And what's accelerating this is smartphones. I mean, everyone in India seems to have a smartphone now. Even the poorest of the poor, they're begging on smartphones. I mean, here they don't accept money via QR codes yet. If you go to China, the beggars won't even accept cash from you. They want you to pay them digitally. Probably within 2 or 3 years, if Mr. Kant's ambitious efforts to install the digital currencies work, the beggars here also will be flashing their QR codes and saying, "BBG, make a QR code there, though." But that is how technology is advancing thanks to our smartphones. It's making the price of all of these sensors drop exponentially. And we're talking about the most amazing sensors you can imagine: accelerometers, gyroscopes, magnetometers, particle sensors, pressure sensors, visibility sensors, 3D vision, all of these advanced sensors, which were not available in India. You can go on Alibaba right now and order them for 50 rupees, 100 rupees at a time. They cost practically nothing. And what this means is that if you take your smartphone apart, you will find in it sensors that would have cost hundreds of thousands of dollars and weighed hundreds of pounds just 30 or 40 years ago. 30 years ago, if you were coming from America to the United States, you weren't allowed to carry electronics. If you were coming from America to India, you weren't allowed to carry sophisticated electronics with you. The U.S. had export controls against supercomputers. This device over here is more powerful than 40 Cray supercomputers. You know the Cray supercomputers that couldn't be imported into America, into India? No one even bothered to stop me at customs when I carried this in the USA or India. It can be freely exported. It's available everywhere. Made in China technology. This is how it is.